Hello, welcome to another GoJS intermediate tutorial. This video will explain and demonstrate the table panel, used for defining GoJS parts whose elements should be arranged in rows and columns. Using GoJS requires programming in JavaScript and familiarity with HTML and CSS. Additionally, this video assumes you understand the basics of GoJS, which are covered in the GoJS Beginner Videos series. The table panel arranges objects in rows and columns. Each object in a table panel is put into the cell referenced by the value of its graphObject.row and graphObject.column properties. The panel looks at the rows and columns for all objects it contains to determine how many rows and columns the table should have. By default, objects are center-aligned in each cell. Not every cell of a table must have a graph object within it. If a column or row has no objects within it, that column or row is ignored. Let's make a quick example. This is the goal. We're going to see how we can use a table panel to achieve it. We'll make a part whose panel type is auto, and give it two elements, a rectangle shape and a table panel. This way, the table panel has a border. Now, we'll enter all the content of the table. The first row is a shape, a text block, and a shape. The second row is four text blocks. Note that we specify the row and column properties for each element. These properties correspond with the cell in the table panel the element belongs in. We did not specify the row property for the elements in the first row. If row or column is not defined for an element, table panel assumes that that element's row or column is zero. Now, load the page. We see all our elements are aligned in the table panel according to their row and column properties. This is a good start, but there's plenty more we can do with table panel to refine our part. Let's set a few properties of table panel. We can draw lines between cells by setting the default row separator stroke and default column separator stroke properties. Let's set both these properties to black. We can also add some space around elements and cells by setting the default separator padding property. Let's set it to 10. Now, reload the page. This is a bit more orderly, and the extra space around the elements of each cell certainly helps the table from feeling too confined. But the title text is only in column 1 of row 0, leaving a completely empty column 2. This would probably look better if title sat between column 0 and column 1. Now we can accomplish this by setting the column span property for the title text block. Since we want this element to span two columns, we'll set the column span property to 2. Now, if we reload the page, we see title covers column 1 and column 2. Additionally, let's position the shapes on either side of the title text block to the far horizontal edges of their cells. For the triangle shape, that means setting the alignment property to go.spot.left. For the rectangle shape, we set the alignment property to go.spot.right. Now look. The triangle and the rectangle shape appear flush to the left and right sides of their cells, respectively, while still allowing for 20 units of padding. Having separator stroke for all rows and columns doesn't look so good, since the title text is being cut in half by a separator. We can control properties of specific rows and columns by use of the RowColumn Definition object. You can set properties for specific rows and columns within your table panel with RowColumn Definition objects. A row column definition describes constraints on a row or a column in a table panel, even if there are no objects in that row or column. A row column definition can also provide information about the actual layout after the table panel has been arranged. There are many properties row column definitions support. We'll demonstrate a few of them now. First, delete the default row and column separator stroke. Then, we'll define a row column definition for row 0 and set its background property to Dodger Blue. Load the page. We now see the first row has a nice blue background. We'll make another row column definition object, this time for row 1. Set its separator stroke property to black, then reload the page. Now there is only one separator in our table panel, denoting the start of the second row. At this point, we've visually accomplished our goal. We've created the part we saw at the beginning of this tutorial. One can, however, clean up their table panel definitions by use of table row and table column panels. Table row and table column panels are special panels that can only be used inside a table panel. You can put all objects for a column inside a table column panel that represents a particular column, and then only need to supply the row property for each object. The same kind of organization can be done with rows using TableRowColumn Panels. Let's demonstrate this with TableRowColumn Panels. Add a TableRowColumn Panel to our TablePanel for row 0. Now move the shapes and text block for row 0 inside this TableRowColumn Panel. Similarly, we'll define another TableRowColumn Panel for row 1, then move all the text blocks in row 1 into this TableRowColumn Panel. Delete all row property definitions for these text blocks. All elements in this TableRowColumn Panel are automatically assigned row 1. Now, while our end result is still the same, this removes some redundant row property definitions and makes our code a bit nicer to look at. That's it for this video. To learn more, visit the intro pages on panels and table panels, or read the full documentation on GoJS.net. Head over to GoJS.net to see hundreds of samples, read more about GoJS features on the intro pages, or peruse the full API documentation. Sign up for an unlimited free trial, and you'll get 30 days of developer-to-developer support for free.